I'm Alexis Van Herkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at a new mode found inside of the Qualifier palette, the new 3D Keyer, which is a new feature in DaVinci Resolve 12. This is a brand new piece of keying technology found inside of DaVinci Resolve that is a little more pleasant to use. So let's take a look at how this works. I've already created a new node for my secondary adjustment. So what I'm going to do is isolate this man's skin tone, because what I want to do is sharpen his face. So having drawn this line, if I turn on the highlight, you can see how close I've gotten with just one drag of the mouse. Now I've got a few other bits that are very close to his skin tone, but they're far away from him, so I'm not going to worry about that too much. So while I'm working at it, I'm going to draw another line. I can draw with highlight turned on. I'm just going to draw a couple of strokes to try and get as much of him as I can. And each stroke I draw generates a patch on this list. If I'm wondering if any given patch is really doing me any good, I can turn it on or off to see what it's contributing. I don't want to draw too many lines and get too many patches because there's another feature I'm going to use along with this. New features in the matte finesse controls in Resolve 12 include clean black and clean white. And these are fantastic controls for post-adjusting the mattes that you're creating. If I go to a high contrast view, you can see that by adjusting clean black, what I'm doing is a combination of despeckling and contrast adjustment to try and eliminate any loose bits from the background. And when I raise the clean white parameter, it does the same thing for the foreground areas of my mat. So it gets rid of speckling, it fills in holes, and you can see it gives me a really nice result. Now I can continue to use the previous matte finesse controls to make adjustments. I've got my in-out ratio control. I can blur the edge just a little bit to knock the edge off. And with just a few adjustments, I have a really nice solid key, which if I play through, you can see is free from chatter. It's just a very smooth key. So if I turn my highlight off, I can turn the paths off. And now I'm going to go into my primary wheels controls, go to page 2, and I'm going to use mid-tone contrast to go ahead and give his face just a little more subtle sharpness, a little more pop. So there's much more to the 3D keyer. This is just a quick overview. If you want more information and a closer look, I suggest you check out my brand new title for Ripple Training, New Features in DaVinci Resolve 12, which covers this and all the other new features in DaVinci Resolve 12, which is a big release. Thanks for watching.